teaching is for learning.
Hi friends, a very good evening to all. Welcome back to my channel, The Fantastic World of Microbiology. This is Jamuna Devi. First of all, I thank everyone for supporting me till date. And many of my well-wishers asked me to do the video through PPT, not in the written format. So hereafter, I will do my presentation in PPT. Thank you friends for your support. Keep supporting me, please. Today we are going to discuss about bacterial structure. Bacterial structure. In my first slide, the bacterial structure, that is the outer layer or cell envelope, consists of two components: rigid cell wall and plasma membrane. The cell envelope encloses the protoplasm, comprising the cytoplasm, cytoplasmic inclusions such as ribosomes, mesosomes, granules, vacuoles, and the nuclear body. You are all well know about the bacterial structure. First, in bacterial structure, we are going to discuss deeply about the cell wall. In this video, I am going to discuss only about the cell wall. In next video, we will discuss plasma membrane. So in this video fully, we are going to discuss about cell wall. What is cell wall? What are the different types of cell wall? What are the components present in the cell wall, etc., etc. This is the bacterial cell anatomy. See this. In the structure, you all know some of the parts, that is capsule, cell wall, plasma membrane, flagella, plasmid, ribosomes, nucleoid, cytoplasm, phyllus. These are all the some of the parts present in the bacterial cell. We are going to discuss about this all structure in detail in the following videos. See, this is the 3D structure of the bacterial cell. In this picture, we can clearly see how this flagella and phyllus are seen. There are so many parts, foot granules, mesosomes, then see the nuclear diagonal coiled structure and all show in this picture, in 3D structure. Cell wall. The cell wall is situated between the capsule and the cytoplasmic membrane. It is about 20 to 30 nanometer in thickness. The cell wall constitutes a significant portion of the dry weight of the cell and is essential for bacterial growth and division. Common to all bacteria. That is, the cell wall is common to all bacteria except some of the species. For example, Mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is a cell wall deficient bacteria. This cell wall is present in between the capsule and the cytoplasmic membrane. So the cell wall, what are all the functions of cell wall means? See, functions. It helps determines the shape of the cell. You all know, without cell wall, there is no definite shape for the cell. So it determines the shape of the cell. It helps protect the cell from osmotic lysis. What is called osmotic lysis? Osmotic lysis are nothing but a cytolysis. Osmotic lysis or cytolysis. The bursting or rupturing of cell membrane due to osmotic movement of water into the cell. When the cell is in hypotonic environment. Hypotonic means when the water tends to move into the cell membrane cannot hold the excessive influx of water. The cell membrane get rupture. So because of that, the cell wall protect the cell from osmotic lysis or cytolysis. Cyto means cell. Lysis of the cell. Then it can help to protect the cell from toxic substances. You all know toxic substances very well. So the cell wall is used to protect the cell from toxic substances. It can contribute to pathogenicity. That's all about the functions of cell wall. Now we are going to see about bacterial cell wall. Bacterial cell wall, after the Christian Graham, who is this Christian Graham? He is the one who developed the Gram-Stein procedure. Gram-Steining procedure is one of the practical procedure. In 1884, he discovered this procedure. It became evident that bacteria could be divided into two major groups. After this, Christian Gram developed this Gram-Steining procedure only. This bacteria is grouped into two major groups, that is Gram-positive bacteria and Gram-negative bacteria. First, we are going to see the short picture of this Gram-positive and Gram-negative cell wall. It's nothing but the Gram-positive cell wall having lipoteichic acid, peptidoglycan and plasma membrane. But in Gram-negative cell wall, the same plasma membrane is present, peptidoglycan is present. Instead of this teichoic acid, here the outer lipid membrane is present. We are going to discuss about this, what are all the structure present in Gram-positive bacterial cell wall and Gram-negative cell wall, and what are all the function it's happening in this Gram-positive and Gram-negative. We are going to see in detail in this video. So, in next, first, peptidoglycan. In Gram-positive cell wall, what is peptidoglycan? That is, it is a common definition for peptidoglycan. First, peptidoglycan means it's a polysaccharides and protein. That is, it consists of polysaccharide and proteins. Peptidoglycan is also known as a murine. It's a polymer consists of sugars and amino acids. Peptidoglycan is a cross-linked polymer of enormous strength and rigidity. It is a polymer composed of many identical subunits. Peptidoglycan differ from one species to another species in their composition and structure, but it is basically a polymer of N-acetylglucosamine, that is NAG and N-acetylmuramic acid, NAM, L-alanine, D-alanine, D-glutamate and a diamino acid. These are all nothing but the amino acid, D-alanine, L-alanine, D-glutamate. This is nothing but the amino acid. But this peptidoglycan is common in Gram-positive and Gram-negative. Both are having peptidoglycan, but it differ from one species to other species. It is a polymer of the same, that is NAG and NAM, and also this contain the same amino acids, L-alanine, D-alanine or D-glutamate and diamino acid. Not the same composition, but this polymer is common in all peptidoglycan. Next, Gram-positive cell wall. In Gram-positive cell wall, the peptidoglycan is thick, that is 15 to 18 nanometer, and more homogeneous than that of the Gram-negative cell wall. But when compared to peptidoglycan, in Gram-negative cell wall, there is a thin form of peptidoglycan layer only present when compared to Gram-positive cell wall. The Gram-positive cell wall contains large amount of peptidoglycan present in several layers that constitutes about 40 to 80% of this dry weight of the cell wall. Dry weight of the cell wall contain 40 to 80%, that is almost of the cell wall contain the peptidoglycan layer. Peptidoglycan is the main component of the cell wall and is responsible for shape and strength of the cell. It is a disaccharide. In Gram-positive cell wall, it is a disaccharide and contains two sugar derivatives, N-acetylglucosamine and N-acetylmuramic acid. These two sugar derivatives are connected by a linkage called beta-1,4 peptide chains. And the N-acetylmuramic acid carries a tetrapeptide chain consisting of D and L amino acids, that is D-glutamic acid and L-alanine, connected to a carboxyl groups. A pentaglycan bridge which connects the tetrapeptide side chains. It is important, this pentaglycan bridge, it's present in only Gram-positive cell wall, not in the Gram-negative cell wall. The pentaglycan bridge which connects the tetrapeptide side chains. So, coming to the structure This is the structure of peptidoglycan in gram-positive silver. You see this disaccharide, N-acetylglucosamine, N-acetylmuramic acid, and having the pentaglycan linkage, connected by pentaglycan linkage having beta-1,4 linkage. This green color is N-acetylmuramic acid, and this red color says N-acetylglucosamine. These two are connected through a beta-1,4 linkage. We already see. It is a disaccharide and contains two sugars. It is beta-1,4 linkage peptide chains. And the N-acetylmuramic acid carries a tetrapeptide side chain. We saw now that in this picture, the green color N-acetylmuramic acid is connected with C. Four colors, yellow and blue, having four tetrapeptides. That is tetrapeptide. Tetra means four. That is four. L-alanine, D-alanine, D-glutamate, like that. Here having now L-alanine, D-glutamate, L-lysine and D-alanine. These four amino acids are present in the N-acetylmuramic acid. This is the structure of peptidoglycan for gram-positive cell wall. Okay guys, next, teichoic acid. Teichoic acid or the polymers of polyribitol phosphate or polyglycerol phosphate containing ribitol and glycerol. Teichoic acid is a polymer. In peptidoglycan, it is a polymer of sugar derivatives. But here, the teichoic acids are the polymers of polyribitol phosphate or polyglycerol phosphate containing ribitol and glycerol. These polymers may have sugars or amino acid substitutes, either as a side chain or within the chain of the polymers. These teichoic acids are of two types, that is wall teichoic acid and lipoteichoic acid. We already saw in the structure of peptidoglycan, that is gram-positive and gram-negative cell wall. This teichoic acid is present only in the gram-positive cell wall, not in the gram-negative cell wall. In gram-positive cell wall, this teichoic acid of two types, that is wall teichoic acid and lipoteichoic acid. They are connected to the peptidoglycan by a covalent bond with the 6-hydroxyl group of N-acetylmuramic acid in the wall teichoic acid and 2 plasma membrane lipids in lipoteichoic acid. That is, you see this, wall teichoic acid is connected to the 6-hydroxyl group of N-acetylmuramic acid, okay, and this lipoteichoic acid is connected to the plasma membrane lipids, so only it is called a lipoteichoic acid. See the structure. Next we are going to see about the functions. Next we saw the structure. Functions of the teichoic acids. They are used as antigen for serological classification of bacteria. You all know about the serological classification. Serological means study of the serum. Then they serve as substrates for many autolytic enzymes. Autolytic means, auto means self-lysis. Self-lysis enzymes. They play a role in normal functioning of the cell wall and provide an external permeability barrier to gram-positive cell wall. They play a role in normal functioning of the cell wall and provides an external permeability barrier to gram-positive bacteria. This acts as a permeability barrier to the gram-positive bacteria. This membrane teichoic acid, or LTA, serves to anchor the underlying cell membrane. This lipoteichoic acid serves to anchor to the underlying cell membrane. That is, that it anchor, it fixed to this cell membrane layer. See the structure. This underpart is cell membrane. This is the plasma membrane, and above is the peptidoglycan layer. This teichoic acid is present. See, this is lipoteichoic acid, and this is also a teichoic acid. This and all come from this peptidoglycan layer. And see, this lipoteichoic acid alone come from the lipid bilayer, that is the plasma membrane of the cell. Plasma membrane of the cell. From this plasma membrane, it connects means it is called lipoteichic acid, and this wall teichic acid is present in the peptidoglycan layer. That's all about teichic acids. Next, teichorinic acid. Teichorinic acid is consist of repeat units of sugar acids such as N-acetyl, mannuric acid or D-glucuronic acid. They are synthesized in place of teichic acids when phosphate supply to the cell is limited. This is an optional one. Teichorinic acid is optional. Instead of teichoic acid, if the cell wall has phosphate supply, phosphate supply is limited in cell wall, means this teichorinic acid will synthesize. It is a repeat unit of sugar acid such as N-acetyl, mannuric acid and D-glucuronic acid. It is the repeat of sugar acid, this two sugar acids. And this is synthesized in place of teichoic acid when the phosphate supply to the cell is very limited only. That's all about the gram-positive bacteria. In gram-positive bacteria, we see about what is peptidoglycan and what is teichoic acid and what is teichorinic acid. That's it. In gram-negative bacteria, the gram-negative cell wall is much more complex than the gram-positive cell wall. Even though this peptidoglycan layer is somewhat thin in this gram-negative cell wall, but the structure is more complex than gram-positive cell wall. What are all this? We will see. Gram-negative cell wall outside the peptidoglycan layer contains three main components, that is lipopolysaccharides, outer membrane and lipoprotein layer, that is present in the outside the peptidoglycan layer. Peptidoglycan layer outside, there are three main components. There are lipopolysaccharides, outer membranes and lipoprotein layer. See, we already saw the structure of gram-negative cell wall in this somewhat inner membrane, that is periplasmic space. This is the outer membrane and lipopolysaccharides and all. This is the structure of gram-negative cell wall. So, coming to the peptidoglycan structure. Peptidoglycan content is in the gram-negative cell wall is significantly less than the gram-positive cell wall. Only 1 to 2 layers of peptidoglycan are present. First, outside the cell membrane, only 1 to 2 layers of peptidoglycan, that is 2 to 8 nanometer. But in that, 80% of dry weight of cell wall contain peptidoglycan in gram-positive cell wall. In here, this is 2 to 8 nanometer, that is only 1 or 2 layers only present outside the cell membrane. Complexed polymer contains two sugar derivatives, N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl noramic acid connected by beta-1,4 linkage peptide chains. N-acetyl muramic acid carries a tetrapeptide side chains consisting of D and L amino acids with meso-diaminopelamic acid. Here in gram-positive we saw something in D and L amino acids, but here it is with meso-diaminopelamic acid. In this, pentaglycan bridge is absent. But in gram-positive cell wall, we saw this pentaglycan bridge is present. Here, this pentaglycan bridge is absent. Next, the very important structure in gram-negative cell wall is lipopolysaccharide. Lipopolysaccharides are nothing but complex molecules present in the outer membrane of the gram-negative bacteria. Structurally, the LPS consists of three main components, that is the lipopolysaccharides. We saw in the structure of gram-negative cell wall, the upper side, that is the outer side of the peptidoglycan, it forms lipopolysaccharides. The three main components are lipid A, core oligosaccharides, and O polysaccharides or O antigens. This is the lipopolysaccharide structure. See here, lipid A, inner core, outer core and O antigen. Inner core, outer core is core polysaccharides. here this down having lipid A structure. So first of all, lipid A. This consists of phosphorylated glucosamine disaccharide units to which a number of non-chain fatty acids are attached. This also consists of hydroxymeristic acid, a unique fatty acid which is associated with endotoxic activity of the LPS. This lipid A, when the bacterial cell are lysed by the immune system, this fragments of membrane containing lipid A are released and it forms fever, shock, diarrhea, like the diseases and all come. This lipid A is a consist of phosphorylated glucosamine disaccharide units, which is a number of long chain fatty acids are attached. See, core oligosaccharide. Next to that lipid A, core oligosaccharides. This core oligosaccharides, the core domain, always contain an oligosaccharides component that attaches directly to the lipid A. In the structure itself, we saw this core polysaccharide is directly attached to this lipid A. It commonly contains sugar such as heptose and 3-deoxy-D-mano of 2-ulosinic acid, also known as KDO, ketodeoxyoctanoate. Octo, it's a octanoate, KDO. This is the sugar present in core oligosaccharide. This is commonly contained sugar. This KDO is very important in core oligosaccharide. Then O polysaccharides or O antigen. A repetitive glycan polymer contained within the LPS is referred to as O antigen. That is, the O antigen is nothing but the repetitive glycan polymer contained within an lipopolysaccharide. It's referred to as O antigen. It is the portion extending outward from the core. It is the portion extending outward from the core. That is, we are all seeing the structure. Outward from this core, the outer core, inner core, and outwards of this core we have this O antigen. It is the portion extending outwards. It has several peculiar sugars and varies in composition between bacterial strains, conferring species-specific antigen specificity. That is, it has several peculiar sugars and carries and varies in composition between bacterial strains. This whole polysaccharides, it's differ from strain to strain. That is, the composition of this O chain varies from strain to strain. For example, in E. coli, this O antigen structure produced 160 different O antigens. This O polysaccharide is contained 160 different O antigen structure. This presence or absence of this O antigen in a cell determines the lipopolysaccharide structure is smooth or rough. Rough lipopolysaccharide or smooth lipopolysaccharide is based upon this O antigen presentation. If full length O chain is present, means this lipopolysaccharide is very smooth, whereas any absence or reduction of this length will cause this LPS to be rough. It is exposed to host immune system. So this function LPS means lipopolysaccharide. LPS is the endotoxin which causes a fever, shock, by activating macrophages and the complement system. I already told this lipopolysaccharides, it is lipid A. The bacterial cells, the bacterial cells are lysed, means lipid A contained membranes released from the cell and causes fever, diarrhea, shock, and even septic shock will occur due to this lipopolysaccharide. There is lipid A. So this is the endotoxin. LOS plays an important role in pathogenesis of bacterial infection. LOS plays an important role in pathogenesis of bacterial infections. O antigens is also used to identify certain microbes in the laboratory. So we already saw O antigen. What are all the specification of O antigen? So because of this O antigen, we can find certain microbes in the clinical laboratory. Next, we are going to see about outer membrane. Outer membrane of the cell wall. That is, the outer membrane is a bilayer structure. Its inner part resembles in composition with that of the cell membrane, while the outer part contains a distinctive component called lipopolysaccharides. The outer membrane has a variety of proteins. This outer membrane is a bilayered structure. Bilayer means it contains two layers. That's the inner part resembles in composition with that of cell membrane. Inner part resembles the cell membrane, while its outer part contains a distinctive component called lipopolysaccharide. Distinctive component called lipopolysaccharide. That is the two layers, the inner layer and the outer layer. The outer membrane has a variety of proteins. What are all the proteins? Porins and outer membrane proteins. What is called porins? Porins. The outer membrane has special channels consisting of protein molecules. Special channels consisting of protein molecules are called porins. They permit the, this is the function of this porin, they permit the passive diffusion of low molecular weight hydrophilic compounds such as sugars, amino acids and certain ions. It permit only this low molecular weight hydrophilic components. Example, sugars, amino acids and ion. This is the function of this porins. They exclude hydrophobic molecules and they serve to protect the cell. These are all the functions of porins. It serves to protect the cell. Then, outer membrane proteins. There are so many outer membrane proteins. Outer membrane proteins C, D, F and 4E and LAMB are the four major protein of the outer membrane and are responsible for most of the transmembrane diffusion of maltose and maltodextrins. Transmembrane diffusion of maltose and maltodextrins. OMPA protein anchors the outer membrane to the peptidoglycan layer. Anchors the outer membrane to the peptidoglycan layer. That is, it fixed to the peptidoglycan layer. The outer membrane also contains proteins such as vitamin B12 and iron siderophore complexes. It also contains a limited number of minor proteins such as enzyme, phospholipases or proteases. That's all about the outer membrane proteins. There are so many outer membrane. The importance are OMP, CDF, 4E and LAMB are the four major outer membrane proteins. OMPA is anchors to the peptidoglycan layer and others are vitamin B12 and iron siderophore complexes. Limited number of minor proteins such as enzymes, phospholipases and then proteases. Next, periplasmic space. In the structure we saw in the gram-positive cell wall and gram-negative cell wall, there is a periplasmic space. In gram-positive cell wall, this periplasmic space lies between the plasma membrane and the cell wall. It is smaller than the gram-negative bacteria. It has relatively few proteins. Enzymes secreted by gram-positive bacteria are called exoenzymes. They often serve to degrade polymeric nutrients. Which one often serve to degrade? This enzyme secreted by the gram-positive bacteria serve to degrade the polymeric nutrients. It's all the periplasmic space of gram-positive bacteria. It is the between plasma membrane and cell wall. It is smaller than the gram-negative and it has contained few proteins. But in gram-negative cell wall, the periplasmic space is the space between cell membrane and outer membrane. Here it is cell wall and plasma membrane. In gram-negative bacteria, it is present in outer membrane and cell membrane in between. This space is filled with a loose layer of peptidoglycan matrix. The space between the cell membrane and the outer membrane is filled with loose layer of peptidoglycan matrix. The periplasmic space of gram-negative bacteria contains many proteins, but in gram-positive, there are limited proteins that participate in nutrient acquisition and many hydrolytic enzymes, beta-lactamases binding proteins, and enzymes that participate in the peptidoglycan synthesis. Polymers of D-glucose called membrane-derived oligosaccharides appear to play a role in osmoregulation. That's all about the gram-positive and gram-negative cell wall. We can clearly see about the peptidoglycan, teichoic acid, teichorinic acid, outer membrane and the periplasmic space of both gram positive and gram negative cell wall. That's all about the cell wall structures of the bacteria. In next video, we are going to see about the plasma membrane in detail and also the cytoplasmic inclusions. Thank you very much, friends, for watching my video. Please subscribe my video and click the bell button. Keep supporting me always, friends. Thank you very much.